need more fuel, more power, a greater anointing for where I am going in you. I knew I could sense it because of what I was going through. And so I began to think about high octane. You know, when you go get gas, they got those three grades, levels. What y'all get? Y'all get the regular, right? Right? I tell you, the regular gas got water in it. I was asking myself, I said, what's the difference in all this gas? He said, that's why the higher gas, it costs more. It don't have all that water in it. You know what it got? It got more oil. It got more oil in it. That premium gas. And see, the older you get, you need some premium oil. You know, because you want to go further with less effort. You don't want to be breaking down on the side of the road. You don't want to hear all that tick, 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 tick. No, you need the premium stuff. See, right, for where I'm going, see, I ain't young as I used to be. I ain't like my son. I need that high octane gas. Say high octane. Because I want to go further.
Please give a warm welcome for Minister Sharon Dominguez.
Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Hallelujah. How many of you need the Lord? Glory to God.
Where would I go without your hand holding me? And how could I live without you? I can't see. Lord, what would I do in life? Where would I go without? How would I handle things? All that I know is I fall.
That you need.
I need you.
But Lord, I need you.
Say now, where would I go?
I can't live without you.
Where would I go without your hand?
I can't move without you.
How would I live without you?
How could I live?
I can't stand without
you.
I can't breathe without you. Free! people, I need the Lord. Tell three people, I need the Lord.
Everybody say,
can't live without. I'm not gonna make it without. To a great God, an awesome God. Let's just stand to our feet and bless the Lord. For I will bless the Lord at all times, and my praise will continually be in my mouth. My soul shall make a boast unto my God, that the humble shall hear and be glad. Oh, magnify the Lord with me. Oh, magnify the Lord with me. Oh, magnify the Lord. Let us exalt his name together. His name is great. His name is awesome. His name is mighty, the mighty God. They just got through singing, how great is our God. He's an awesome God. Oh, glory to his name. I do give all glory and honor and praise to God, who is the head of my life, the bishop of my life. Hallelujah. To Apostle H. Daniel Wilson, my spiritual father, I thank God for him for giving me an opportunity in this platform. For so many years, he trusted me with his people. I thank God for that man of God, my father, my spiritual leader. He leads and he guides and he covers me. He prays for me. And I don't take this opportunity for granted. Thanking and praising God for our First Lady, our spiritual mom, Pastor Beverly LaJoyce Wilson, awesome and anointed exhorter. She leads us into the presence of the Lord every Sunday, praying for us, covering us. Thank God for my spiritual mom. All of you, my brothers and sisters in Christ. My daughter is here. My baby girl, Amber Dominguez. I don't know if I have any other family member. My husband, in his absence, the priest, the provider and protector of our home. He can't make it today, but I know he's somewhere praying for me. It's good to have somebody praying for you. Hallelujah. I know I have some guests here. If they could just raise their hand if you came. God bless you. God bless you. Thank you, prophetess. God bless you all for coming. Mimi, love you. It's just good to be supported. Amen. You can have your seats in the presence of the Lord. If I forget anything, just charge it to my head and not my heart. We're going to go straight into the word. Jeremiah 33, 1 through 3. Jeremiah 33, 1 through 3. And it reads, then the word of the Lord. Oh, I'm sorry. You can stand for the reading of the word. You can stand for the reading of the word. Then the word of the Lord came to Jeremiah. Read along with me in the Amplified Version. Then the word of the Lord came to Jeremiah the second time, while he was confined in the court of the guard, saying, thus says the Lord who made the earth, the Lord who formed it to establish it. The Lord is his name. Call to me and tell you, even show you great and mighty things, things which have been confined and hidden, which you do not know and understand and cannot distinguish. Amen, amen. Our title for this morning is Prayer, the Master Key. Unlocking God's purpose for your life. Prayer, the Master Key. God is unlocking purpose in your life. Just tell somebody, God is unlocking. God is unlocking some things. He unlocking some things. You can have your seat in the presence of the Lord. God is unlocking his purpose, his plans, and his power. So get ready for access. Tell the person next to you, get ready for access. is having a conversation with God, communing with God. Never underestimate the power of prayer. The Word of God tells us we are to always pray and don't faint. Pray without ceasing, for the fervent and effectual prayers of the righteous availeth much. That means when you pray, expect results. Hallelujah. God is unlocking his purpose, his plans, and his power. But we're going to have to call on him. We're going to have to communicate with him. Prayer is a dialogue, not a monologue. When we have a conversation with somebody, you don't do all the talking. That means somebody else got to talk too. So when you talk to him, expect God to allow him to talk back to you. I know we just be going and going, and I know I do it sometimes. Them tongues be grrr. But sometimes I got to get quiet and hear what God want to say next. A plan is an intention. I want to back up for a minute. God is unlocking his purpose, his plans, and his power. Purpose is the reason that you were created, the reason that you exist. And I just wanted to come today just to encourage someone. And the prophetic word confirms what the Lord has given me today, because Prophetess Stacy released about how we get weary sometimes when we start walking in our purpose. But I just wanted to encourage you today that you will learn your purpose or discover your purpose, some of you. And some of you, I want you to be encouraged to continue in your purpose. And don't get weary in well-doing. But be steadfast and unmovable, abounding in the work of the Lord, knowing that your labor, have a revelation that your labor, your works, your purpose is not in vain. Amen. Your purpose is the reason that you were created, the reason that you exist, that you are here. A plan is the intention or decision concerning something that you are about to do, an idea, a strategy. Jeremiah 29 says, I know the plans, God says, that I have for you, peace and not of evil. See, we have a plan, but God has a plan. Many are the plans of a man, but the plans of God, his purpose is what's going to stand. Amen. And then the power, dunamis, exousias, God is unlocking it today. Authority, God uses power to accomplish his purpose in his people. God doesn't give us power so that we can be all that we want to be. Hello. God gives us power so that we can be all that he wants us to be. See, it's different when you want power just to do your own thing. And then you wonder why you don't feel the explosive, you don't have the authority. But ask and seek God for the power to do what he will have for you to do. And that's the shift. That's what makes all the difference. I hope I'm helping somebody. He gives us power so that we can be all that he wants us to be. Have anybody here ever been locked out? Ever been locked out of anything? I ain't say kicked out. I know some of y'all been kicked out. But I'm talking about been locked out. Locked out of your house, those things that belong to you. Locked out of your car, your account. Yep, that thing. That thing that just flashed across your mind. Because we have all been there. Those things that belong to you. And when we find ourselves in a place where we locked out of our car, you start patting your pockets and start like, wait a minute, I know they here somewhere. For us ladies, we go digging in our purse and we start scrambling. I mean, we start digging. Then the panic sets in, because you come to a realization that you have no longer have access to that which belongs to you. But say, access. Hallelujah. One of my beloved daughters, who will remain nameless, but it begins with a M and ends with a IA, constantly locks herself out of our house. So when she moved out of her own house, moved into her own house, stands to reason she got locked out of her apartment. But no worries. But see, when she was locked out of our house, she could call me. She could call her dad, someone to let her in. But when she got her own place, she couldn't call mama. She couldn't call daddy. So what she had to do was she had to call the authorities. She had to call management, the ones who were the only ones who were able to unlock her door to her apartment. Why? Because they had something called a master key. A master key is significantly different from any other key. That one key can unlock and gain entry and access to any door under its authority. It was limited, but yet it had authority over that area. Oh, but I know somebody that have all authority. I know somebody that is not, don't have limited access, that has total access. His name is Elohim. One of his Elohistic names. His name is Elohim. He's the creator of all things. Jesus said, I have all power in my hand, in heaven and in the earth. My name is El Shaddai, because I'm the Almighty God. I'm the many-breasted one. I have full authority. My name is El Elyon. Anybody know his name? He's because I am the Most High God. Glory to God. Get ready for access. Praise you, Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah. So here we go. Listen, something devastating happened in my life. I mean, the unthinkable. I got locked out of my iPhone. I know you can't even imagine what I was dealing with. I'm telling you, I said Sprint got jokes. I just woke up one morning and I no longer had access. My whole life flashed before my eye. All of my pictures, all of my apps, my accounts, all my contacts. I began to think about, what am I gonna do? How do I gain access? I start praying, y'all. You know, that first thing we do when we start panicking, because I start sweating, my palms start getting wet. So I got my oil. And I said, devil, you gonna lie. You have come up out of my phone. I command this opening in Jesus' name. I come against all malfunction, all confusion. I began to anoint that phone. I said, open in Jesus' name. Came back, no access. The Lord said, you're going to have to go to the authorities. Hallelujah. So I went to Sprint first, and they were unable to unlock it because I didn't have an Apple passcode. I want y'all to know, you have to have an Apple ID. Your all of your contact, all of your information is secure. It's not something easy somebody can just take. I just want to encourage somebody with that. So they said, you're going to have to go to Apple. So when I went to Apple, they were the only ones that were unable to unlock my phone. I didn't even have an Apple ID, but they were able to change the passcode for me. And so the Lord was letting me know they're the ones that have authority. They're the ones that is able to unlock it. And so God is letting us know today, there's some things that are locked up, but we're going to have to come to him. All of your giftings, all of the promises God has for you, all the things, your talents, and he has so much, so your hopes and your dreams, all the power and authority, he has it for you. But God's saying he wants you to come to him.
Hallelujah. Jeremiah is commonly known as the weeping prophet. Based on his wish to have a fountain of tears with which he might weep for the slain of his own people. Jeremiah 9:1. It was this trait of deep empathy for those he continually chastised is what made him different from any other prophet. For 40 years he served as God's spokesman for Judah. But when he spoke, no one listened. He underwent severe deprivation, poverty, just to deliver God's prophecy. And you think you've been through something. Have you been through anything like the prophet Jeremiah? He was thrown in prison. He was thrown into wells, rejected by neighbors, family, and friends, kings and priests throughout his life. Jeremiah stood alone, declaring God's message of doom, telling the people to repent of their sins, announcing the new covenant, and weeping over the fate of his beloved country. Through it all, he was obedient to his call. Amen. That was just a little background for Jeremiah. I just wanted to share it with you so that we could just get an understanding of what's going on and how he came to that place of such weeping because of his assignment. And sometimes our assignment will bring pain. Sometimes our purpose will bring pain. There's a price for saying yes. But what do you do when your purpose brings disappointment, hurt, pressure? Some of you have been so discouraged, you stepped away. You walked away from what God had given you to do. You sat down. But I want to encourage you today, it's time to get up. It's time to get up and it's time to go forward. When God called Jeremiah, he told him that he was ordained. He said, before you were in your mother's womb, I ordained you to be a prophet to the nations. I ordained you, I appointed you, and I anointed you. Oh, he said, only don't be afraid. And then the Lord put forth his hand. And he touched his mouth. And the Lord said, behold, I have put my words in your mouth. I hear the Lord saying, I have put my words in your mouth. Close your eyes and just imagine God stretching forth his hand over your mouth. Putting his words in your mouth, not the words of the enemy. We do a lot of things with our mouths. We say a lot of things with our mouth, but say, Lord, touch my mouth. He said, I have set you over the nations and over kingdoms to root out, to pull down and to destroy, to throw down, to build and to plant. It doesn't say anything about being persecuted. God told him all the things that he would be and he would do. But he never told him about the other issues. He never told him about being rejected, about being locked up, about being in prison. If God had told you, would you have gone? If you had known all the hell you was going to have to go through, the price you was going to have to pay for saying yes. But when you call upon him, he said he will answer you. Glory to God. Glory to God. Jeremiah 20:9. Jeremiah had become so distraught. He began to complain. He began to tell God, you have deceived me. And you told me to go and to tell your people of their sins. And this is what have happened to me. I'm not going to speak your word no more. He said, I'm angry with you. And he said, I will not mention your name anymore. He said, I'm not going to say your name. I'm not going to talk to nobody. I'm not going to go. But see, Jeremiah forgot. God stretched forth his hand. He forgot God stretched forth his hand. And he put his hand over his mouth and he placed his words in his mouth. See, when God put it in you, ain't nothing you can do to bring it up out of you. If God did it, ain't nothing you can do to stop it. He said, I'm not going to do it no more. I'm not going to speak no more of your name. But it says that his word was in my heart like a burning fire shut up in my bones. Because the word is alive, y'all. Because the word is quick. Because the word is powerful. Because the word is sharp. The word of God was in him. You can't put that out. Man should not live by bread alone, but by every word. Jesus is the living word. He stretched forth his hand and he put his words on the inside of him. He said, so I got to get up. I surrender. I yield. I'm sorry. It's like a burning fire. Sometimes we go through things. But when we just begin to think of the goodness of Jesus, get our mind off of what we're going through. Get our minds off of what somebody said. Get our minds off of what somebody did. Can I give you a flash news today? Everybody not going to like you. Everybody not going to like you. You don't need everybody to like you. You just need the right ones to like you. You just need Jesus to like you. I wish I had three people to know. All you need is the right ones. You always going to have somebody. Did nobody want to have nothing to do with Jeremiah, but God did. In them dark places, God was with him. When they talked about him, when shame and reproach, God said, you mine, I love you, I ordained you, I called you. God gave him his identity. He told him who he was. Don't let nobody tell you who you are. You let God tell you who you are. God says that you're created in my image and in my likeness. God said that let God begin to tell you that you are fearfully and you are wonderfully made by me. Let God say you are my masterpiece, a work of art. Let God begin to tell you who you are. Poetry in motion. Let God tell you that you are his beloved, that you are his chosen. He was listening to them, and sometimes that can wear on you, but you got to go in that secret place. You got to get in the place where God is just you and God. See, I've been there in them dark times, them dark places where I felt so alone, but I wasn't alone. Because sometimes we got to get, God got to put us in isolation. He got to put us aside so he can have a conversation. Because we so busy. We got so much clutter, so much going on, so many voices. But God know how to get your attention. Lock your iPhone up. Let that check don't drop in your bank account on payday. Oh, yeah, he got my undivided attention. What's going on, God? He knew how to get us our attention. See, I hear God the clearest when I'm in trouble. I mean, I it's so clear. I don't miss a word. It's in the quiet time, the quiet place, when I just need to hear from you, Lord. And I remember when I was in those dark times, and the Lord began to speak to me, and he told me that every giant in my life was coming down. I heard it as clear as a bell. He said, every giant that is in your life was coming down. He said, don't you let nobody put your fire out.
Don't you let nobody paralyze your purpose. I'm talking to somebody today. Don't let nobody derail your destiny. You keep moving because them giants, they are coming down. Because prayer is a game changer. The fervent and the effectual prayers of the righteous availeth much. You're going to get some result when you begin to pray, when you begin to cry out, when you begin to call upon the Lord, because he hears us when we cry, when we call out to him. Glory to God. Give God a hand clap of praise for hearing. Say, I'm not going to let nobody put my fire out. Burn in me, Lord. Burn in me, Lord. Burn in me, Lord. Say it until you feel it. Say it until you believe it. Say it until you ignite it. Say it until your passion comes back. Say it until you're moving forward. Say it until you get up. Say it until. Jeremiah said, it's like fire burning in my heart because his word was in him. Spirit of the living God, Yorabashi and Arabas. Hurabase, who am I talking to? The enemy will change the game on you. But prayer is a game changer. God said the game may change, but don't let the game change you. He said, same game, different players. Same spirit, just coming in a different form. The enemy is not an innovator. He's not a creator. He don't got no new tricks. He come in the same way, just dressed different. God say, it's the same game, just different players. Fee, fi, fo, fum. I smell the blood of Jesus once. The anointed one. The blood works. The blood never loses its power. The blood. What can take away my sin? What can make me whole again? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. Hallelujah. Nothing that the enemy can do to you. When he start coming, say, just remember, every giant is coming down. Just begin to say, fee, fi, fo, fum. Rita, I smell the blood of the anointed one. Come on, say that with me. Fee, fi, fo, fum. I smell the blood of the anointed one. And his name is Jesus. Give God him cock a prayer. Prayer, the master key. God say it's time to rise up and it's time to go forth. For behold, I have given you power to tread upon serpents and scorpions and over all the powers of the enemy. And nothing shall in any means hurt you. Nothing shall harm you. Nothing shall stop you. Nothing shall destroy you. Because you hold the key. Prayer. The master key. Little prayer. Little power. Much prayer. Much power. Jeremiah. I heard somebody about to say, no prayer. No prayer. No power. Let's go to Jeremiah 33, 2 and 3. Thus says the Lord who made the earth
and the Lord who formed it to establish it. The Lord is his name. Hallelujah. He made the heavens. He made the earth. He established it. He said, call unto me and I will answer you. And I will show you great and mighty things. All you have to do is call. He said, all you have to do is ask. Remember where Jeremiah was when God came and spoke to him for the second time in prison. God said, just call me. Yeah, he can do it without you asking him, but he wants us to just ask. He said, seek me where I may be found. Ask and doors will be open. Seek and you will find him. Knock and the doors open. And sometimes we want to ask, but we just want to stop it there. But he said, everyone that asketh, receiveth. So when we begin to ask, he said, keep on asking. If you don't get it, seek, keep on seeking. You don't get it? If you still don't get it, keep knocking. Keep on knocking till you get an answer. Jesus said, just ask of me. That means to make a request. Philippians 4:6 said, make your requests be made known unto God. Be anxious for nothing. Don't worry. No worries. No worries. He said, let your request be made known to me. Just all you have to do is ask and let your request be made known. Begin to pray and the peace of God that surpasses all understanding will keep you. He said, when you begin to ask of me, I will answer. He said, not only will I answer. He said, I'm the only one that have the answer. But not only do I have the answer, he said, I am the answer. He said, I am that I am. Whatever you need me to be, I am that. That thing that just crossed your mind, I am that. Whatever you need, he said, make your requests be made known unto me, and I will give you direction. And watch God work. I hear the Lord saying, it is written. Stand to your feet. Stand to your feet. 1 Corinthians 2:9. Let your request be made known unto God. He has the answer. When the righteous cry out, when we begin to call upon the name that is above every name, he will answer you. I may not answer when you call, especially if you call at 2 a.m. You ever get them group texts? Had to turn my phone off. I'm not answering 20 people in a group text at 2:00 a.m. But you can call them in the morning. You can call them in the evening. You can call them at midnight and he will answer you. I hear the Lord say, eyes have not seen, neither ears heard. It haven't even entered into your heart. The things that I have in store for you, you and you. Eyes haven't seen, nor ears heard. It haven't even entered into your heart. The things God said I have in store for you. But I'm revealing it unto you. I'm revealing it unto you. I'm revealing it unto you. You're going to help me down. I'm revealing it unto you. I'm revealing it unto you. I'm revealing it by my spirit. Spirit of the living God. He said, all you got to do is call me. And I'm going to show up. I'm going to show up in unusual places. I'm going to show up in unusual ways. You can't see it right now because it would frighten you unless I reveal it. So I'm hiding some things from you right now. But I'm opening up some treasure chests because I have this treasure in you, my earthen vessels. So get ready for the release. Get ready for the unveiling. Get ready for the reveal. Get ready for God to begin to show you. He's showing you. He's revealing it to you now.
great things, mighty things by his spirit. Lift your hands. Ministers and elders, take your places. Remain standing. I just want to pray for you. I want to speak this decree over you. I decree the word of the Lord will come to you as I use prayer as the master key. I declare that what's promised, the revelation, because it's the Lord who made the heavens and the earth that gives elevation. So cry aloud and don't ever hold back. Lift up your voice like a trumpet without slack. Seek the Lord while he may be found. Call on him, he's close and around. We proclaim the Lord is his name, and he's sure to answer. Call, cry, shout, and speak out. He'll show us great and mighty things without doubt. I declare hidden, unsearchable things to be revealed through prayer, the word, and diligent seek. We will enter with the key, with much authority, dominion, and power have we. We decree that prayer is the master key. God bless.
Woo! Dominguez is so powerful, and we love her here at the Valley. We know that you were blessed by that amazing, awesome, anointed word that she just gave. And we just want you to not just be hearers of it, but doers also, so that you can continue to be everything God has called you to be. Well, we don't want you to leave without just considering donating to us. Once again, if you're watching us on Facebook, you can just hit that donate button. But also, you can go to our app or our Valley website and do online giving, or you can text to give with the information down below. Well, we also don't want you to leave unless you have accepted Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. We just want you to know that everything that we do here at the Valley leads us to this important point of the Valley experience, where you can come into the kingdom of God. God sent his only son, Jesus Christ, for our sins to die, and he rose on the third day. So all you have to do is believe and confess that. So let's just pray. Father God, we just love you. We thank you for everyone who's watching us online, and we thank you, oh Lord God, that you had them in mind when they turned on and watched us. We know it's not by accident that they're viewing us. So Father God, as they're watching us, if they have not accepted you as their Lord and Savior, we just ask, oh Lord God, that you come into their heart, oh Lord God, as they confess Jesus as their Lord and come into their life and let them discover and learn more about you. It's in Jesus' precious name that we pray. Well, if you did that and you want to continue to connect with us, we have a connection card on our website or on our Valley app. Fill that out and we're more than welcome to just connect with you further along. Well, today is over, but don't forget, we have our Born to Be series this Wednesday online only. Go to our YouTube, Facebook, and our website and check it out. Till then, see you later, Valley.